This is your KCTV5 news update.
KCTV5 is tracking a Leavenworth County man's extradition back to Kansas from Oklahoma. Tonight we're learning he may not get here until next week. Donnie Jackson Jr. is accused of killing his two sons and taking his daughters. Police arrested him after a manhunt across state lines. Jackson's sons were found dead after they missed a soccer game, and the daughters were nowhere to be found. Police then caught up with Jackson and those two girls late Saturday in Eric, Oklahoma, about 7 hours from KC. He was charged earlier this week and signed an extradition waiver yesterday. But the Leavenworth County Sheriff's Office tells KCTV5 he will not be back until after the weekend. His sons, 14-year-old Logan and 12-year-old Austin, were both students at Lansing Middle School. The daughters Jackson took off with are okay. According to obituaries posted online, services for the two young boys are planned for tomorrow and Monday. Some voters in our area will be able to cast their ballot at Arrowhead come Tuesday. That announcement coming from the Chiefs earlier this month. It is in an effort to allow people to vote in person and socially distance. This right here is video from yesterday. You can see the parking lot is already being set up for voter turnout. You cannot vote early at Arrowhead, though, only on Election Day from 6 a.m. to 7 p.m. And you do have to be a resident of KC Mo within Jackson County. But for some, your normal polling place actually might be more convenient.
My voting station is like 2 blocks from my house, so I'll be going there, and I'll be there early as I can get there.
The Chiefs are planning on making Election Day memorable for a lot of people. If you go there to cast your vote, you will walk away with a Chiefs-branded I Voted sticker. And Arrowhead is not alone in its mission to get people out and voting. More than 24 arenas and stadiums across the whole country are opening up. More than 20 NBA and NFL teams are offering up their arenas and stadiums as early voting sites or day of polling locations.
They've also loaned their people, and so really come alongside the county to provide additional manpower resources. They're used to having 35,000 people show up to a concert, things like that. So voters, you know, easy peasy for them.
Teams are involved in nearly every aspect of the voting process. For example, Charlotte residents have been able to vote during Carolina Panthers football games. Detroit's Ford Field will store ballots and election equipment for safekeeping in case of a recount. And you can get ready for Election Day right here with us on KCTV5. Our campaign 2020 special is tomorrow. You'll hear from local experts and analysts on the historic election at 4 p.m. right after the Chiefs game.
Wind will increase as we head through late tonight, say about 10-11 p.m. And by about that time, the winds will be out of the northwest in Kansas City and just about everywhere. We might see those gusts up to 25 miles per hour as we head through tomorrow. As far as your scarecast, not so scary. We've been talking about the forecast being pretty pleasant through the remainder of tonight. So if you are just getting ready to go out to do some trick-or-treating, I don't think you'll need a heavy coat as temperatures will be steadily dropping into the middle 50s by 10 o'clock. Here's live power Doppler. Not much to show you, and I don't anticipate using that a whole lot for the next week, and I'll explain why in just a second. This is the cold front that we're tracking. This will again move down to the south and east, and it's going to continue to bring in some cooler air as we head through tomorrow. It'll filter in through Monday morning, dropping those temperatures down near freezing. But as we look at the upper level pattern, things will start to change where we see a more ridge kind of develop as we head through the beginning and early of next week. And this ridge will lead to much drier air, sunshine, and some warmer temperatures, especially as it shifts off to our east, where winds will be out of the south and southwest. So 70s are a possibility as we head through next week. And I'll show you that in our 7 day here coming up in just a sec. Here's our Arrowhead Stadium forecast. During tailgating, it might be a little chilly, maybe a little breezy, wind between 15 and 25 miles per hour, but still mainly sunny. Temperatures will be in the middle 40s at kickoff during the noon hour, warming to about 47 degrees as we head through halftime. Fourth quarter will be right around 50 degrees. That's going to be our high temperature as we head through the day on Sunday. But the good news is things really rebound as we head through Monday already. So not expecting a huge change as we head through, or at least a prolonged change in these cooler temperatures as we head through the end of the weekend. Here it is, our Security Bank 7 day forecast as I take a step out of here. Unfortunately, as I just learned that the Sporting KC game has been canceled, so we'll remove that icon here shortly. Again, 32 expected Monday morning, 62 as we head through Monday afternoon. And look at this, 70 Thursday, Friday, Saturday, with overnight lows in between the 40s and the 50s. So
turn to KCTV5 News for the latest all day. This is your personalized update because KCTV5 News stands for you.